Yesterday we have studied about the characteristic features of management as well as objectives of management, different objectives of management like goal oriented and all. Today we are going to talk about important significance of management as well as nature of management. Significance in the sense we are talking about how important is management or what kind of a role management plays in the organization. We are going to talk about it. And then nature of management. In this you will be able to describe the significance of management as well as nature of management. So what is the significance of management here? Helps in achieving group goals as well as personal objectives. See, the last day itself, last video I told you that group goals are nothing but organizational goal as well as personal objective. It has to link up. The personal objective as well as group goal should be linked. Then only organization can achieve the objective. It cannot ignore personal objectives of the employees as well as group goals, because certain times the employee may have an objective towards his work that should be respected by the management. In order to achieve the group goal, it may help. If the management ignores personal objectives, says only to go within the group goals, it will not. Because sometimes employees may ask that I want to reach this particular target by this date or by this time and all. They will give respect to that. Why they will give? Because the objective is also reached along with the personal objective. I am not talking about the purely personal objective at home. I am talking personal objective in relation to achieving the work target. Therefore, management takes most care, helps the employees in achieving group goals as well as personal objective of the organization. Next is management increases the efficiency. Yes, by giving targets to the people, to the employees. Okay, and by giving different tasks at various levels. If you have achieved this one task, next day it will give another task. It improves your efficiency. And effectiveness also increases when you are doing the work in the organization. Management always looks into the employees' performance levels, and therefore the efficiency of the employees also increases. As I told you, management is a continuous process. In this it will also come. The employees are given continuous task after task. In that process we are learning so many new things. So many innovations are taken by the management and it is passed on to the employees to achieve the goals or objectives. Next is creates a dynamic environment. The other day itself I told you in the characteristic features of management that management is dynamic in nature. Creates a dynamic environment. What does it mean? Creates a dynamic environment means changing situations. We have to be on par. We should keep up with the ongoing developments in the environment, business environment. In the third chapter, we will be coming only to the business environment. We will talk about so many different environments like social environment, legal environment, and business environment. So many are there. In this, political environment. In this, you should keep pace with the ongoing conditions. Every now and then there is a change. Therefore, it creates a dynamic environment. Management always creates a dynamic environment. Now you see all the software companies, people are working from home. Previously, few employees were given chance to work from home. But now every organization, people are working from home. How to upload videos, how to go with the internet conditions and all, we are learning different levels. Everybody has got the work, but work is not affected. That is what? Management is creating dynamic environment is this only. Without hampering your work, there is no doubt about it, 100%. The work is not disturbed at all. Work is going on even in these conditions. That is why it creates a dynamic environment and always alive. There is no question of, static nature in management. There is no question of static nature in management. It is completely dynamic, ever changing, ever running, continuous. Then helps in development of society also. See, when we are doing something for the organization and when new tasks are given to us, like to increase our efficiency, it relates to us personally also. Personally also I am developing. Personally also I am developing. That is why management is helping us. That is why management is very significant. It plays a significant role in the organization. In the management level, there are always people who are very, very innovative and creative. Generally, I appreciate them for the creativity and the fast forward. They are very fast forward in creating a dynamic environment. It's very, very good actually. Therefore, how management is significant means because it is helping in achieving group goals and as well as our personal goals also. Then management is increasing our efficiency. We are able to do different tasks with lots of innovation. We have to think. If they give us one task, we have to think. We try to search for so many ways and means to achieve that or to have that task with us, to see that result is good, and creates a dynamic environment, always ever changing, ever live it is, almost it is live. Next is helps in development of society. Helps in the development of society. If society development means it won't go into the society and develop, planting trees and all, no. Society development means individually when we are developing, definitely society is developing. When I get some innovative ideas regarding an organization, personally also I may apply in that term. And in personal life also when I apply, what will happen? Definitely I have a development that I will show to 10 people around me. They have become innovative, they become creative. In this, along with my professional efficiency, personally also I am developing. Therefore, management helps in these things in the society, in the organization. Therefore, these are the important points you should note on. Children, when you are reading this lesson, especially significance of management, take some examples, live examples, know whatever is happening, and then link them to the existing. You also don't sit static in your house or stick to only one lesson, whatever we are teaching. Go through each heading, subheading, and take the live examples. Now, at present, what is the condition? Current affairs, you should have that knowledge, that link up. If it is not there, it is very difficult, because you should be updated with the theoretical knowledge as well as the practical things going outside. Okay, children? So this is all about your importance of management. Now we will go with the nature. First of all, what is management? What is its nature? People always, in economics also, we try to analyze what is economics. Is it an art? Is it a science? Is it mathematics? Is it anything else other than that? Therefore, even management also. What is management here? Is it a science? Is it mathematics? Is it an art? Is it a profession? Yes, management is everything. Management is everything. Management is an art. What is meant by art here? Art is skillful and personal application of existing knowledge to achieve desired goals. Skillful and personal application. Skillful and personal application of existing knowledge. These two, if you are not there, then it is a problem. Skillful and personal application. I have studied. I might have done PhD. What is the use if I don't know how to put it in practice? Because theoretical knowledge full. I have full to the utmost possible extent I have knowledge. I can share with so many people theoretically. When it comes to application, that is why I am telling you, when the importance of management, when you are reading this lesson, you should see the conditions also, how Chief Minister is taking care of, how different organizations, managements are asking employees to work from home, what kind of innovations they are making, all that you should have that live, updates with you. because you have to apply this in future when you are becoming a management. When you are becoming management, you should know how to apply all this in your life. These are all these. When you are having the theory with you, this personal application is very, very important. That means you need to have innovations, ideas, creation, skills. What kind of skills you have? All that you should implement in your management. That is why management is an art. Art is what? Skillful and personal application of existing knowledge. Now I know, suppose I have learned art like drawing. I know very well. My teacher taught me one book, she gave me, drawing book. I have drawn everything, colored everything very nicely. They have done. Then teacher asked me to draw something else. She said, imagine one environment, draw it. Draw the case. Because I was stuck only to that book. And I don't have any idea about that art outside that book. That means I have not applied my brain over and above that book. Then I cannot become an artist. Management is also like that. It is an art. When you know, suppose if I become HR manager, if I want to become HR manager and I have done MBA HR, that theoretical knowledge I should be able to apply in my life. When I am becoming HR manager, I should know, because live environment I am working. Hundreds of people I come across. When I am coming across hundreds of people, I should know how to tackle things. So this idea to develop theory is very much required. And your brain, sharpness of your brain is also very much required. Therefore, management is an art. Existing knowledge you are applying with the ideas, the skills with you, whatever. There only you are developing as a professional. You are developing as a management professional. Okay? This is what is management is an art. In this, existence of theoretical knowledge. First of all, you should have knowledge. What kind of knowledge? Not only related to your particular work. You should be an all-rounder. Knowing everything around you as well as within you. This is called existence of theoretical knowledge. Theoretical knowledge doesn't have any barricades or territories. Theoretical knowledge is wide, open to everybody. Today when we know about coronavirus, 150 websites we are watching and n number of channels we are looking into, because to know something new, what is new about coronavirus. So theoretical knowledge when we get, upon that we should analyze. You should know the reasons. You should analyze on your own. Then creation starts. There the application of brain comes. So first you should have existence of theoretical knowledge. After that you go with personal application. Okay, I have studied something. I want to apply it somewhere. Physics if you take. I have studied about electricity. How to connect two wires in a parallel or in series, I should know. So that I will do an experiment. This is what is application of your brain in your personal experiments. Next, based on practice and creativity depends always. The art management depends on your practice and creativity. How far you are able to create. Next one is management as a science. Management as a science. What is management as a science here? Systematized body of knowledge. People will have knowledge. Hundreds of people have knowledge. Even I have knowledge, of course, for that reason. Systematized body of knowledge is required here. As and how I like I not work. Mathematics, when you are doing a problem, if you put first result, that is first answer if you put and then do the steps, it won't work. So management is also systematized body of knowledge. You should have some planning for that. Next, principles based on experimentation. All the principles, whatever you are implementing in the organization, should be based on experimentation. Previously you should have done some experiment on that. then only principles will be based on that. Understood? Principles will be based on experimentation. Next is universal validity. What is meant by universal validity? Universal validity means whatever principles you are following in the on this experimentation, there should be universally accepted principles. Not just like just like that for my organization I am giving the principle, there is no universal validity, I am not bothered. No, it is wrong. Principles, when you are experimenting, the principles which you are putting, they should have some universal validity. That is why it is called a science. Management is also working like a science. Okay, next is management as a profession. Management as a profession. We are all professionals. What is meant by professional? Everybody cannot have management skills. Everybody cannot have management skills. Very few people will be there who have management skills. That you should accept. Having theoretical knowledge and applying them in within the group of people, 150 people, is very difficult. Management is well-defined body of knowledge. As a science, systematized body of knowledge and well-defined body of knowledge. Systematized body of knowledge with a well-defined. Well-defined knowledge you should have. Knowledge should not be confusing. And then restricted entry. What is meant by restricted entry here? All people, as I told you, all people cannot become managers. All people cannot go into management. Professional association. What is meant by professional association? You will be, once you go with the higher educations, you will have some kind of a natural decency that comes. That is called a professional association. Next is ethical code of conduct. What is ethical code of conduct? You have some morals towards your employees. You have some morals towards your employees. That is what is called ethical code of conduct. Next is service motto. You will become service motto. You are, means when you are into the management, when you are doing some service for the organization, you will have this definitely even with the employees. Therefore, you look into the welfare of all the employees in the organization as well as to the outside public also. That is what is called service motto. Children, now we have studied. What we have studied? Importance of management, helps in achieving goals, as well as group goals, as well as personal goals. Management increases efficiency, creates a dynamic environment, and helps in the development of society. A nature of management, management as an art, management as a science, and management as a profession. These three we have studied. Now children, after this one more video I am going to give you. In that I will give you the assignment part of it also, and then I will send you the worksheet. Thank you very much, my dear.